Hi, and welcome to my talk, Contextual Approach Towards More Accurate Duplicate Bug Report Detection. This is work done by Anahita, Alipour, who couldn't make it today, but I, Abram, Hindle, will be presenting it, and me and Eleni, Stroulia, we supervise Anahita at the University of Alberta. So we're focusing here on software bugs and software bug reports. So these are issue trackers where bugs are recorded. Sometimes they're defects, sometimes they're enhancements. they're generally filled out by various stakeholders, which could be developers, QA people, managers, and oftentimes users, and a wide range of users at that. So what often happens is two users stumble across the same problem. For instance, the first issue here says email app clears to field when contact name contains non-ASCII characters. The second bug report says email app can't process contact names with special character in it. Both of these pretty well say the same thing, but special characters and non-ASCII characters are meant to be the same idea. So in these bug reports we can see that they might be marked as duplicate. So in the second one we might mark it as a duplicate of the first. And this is usually up to the job of either a triager or the developer. Now, why do these duplicate bug reports exist? Well, researchers such as Bettenberg et al. Suggest there's a wide variety of issues, range from carelessness to misunderstanding features, to technical issues with the software issue tracker system, to inappropriate design. But what a lot of this comes down to is a lack of domain knowledge by some of the users using the bug tracker. Users are not software experts. In many cases, they don't have to be, they're not supposed to be, and they don't share the same domain knowledge as developers, and thus, the things that they put into the bug tracker might not be described in the same way that a developer would describe them. So, why is detecting a duplicate bug report important? Well, duplicate bug reports have to be triaged and have to be read and analyzed. Every time you have to read the bug report, you're basically using up time. So if the bug reports say the same things, by rereading them, you're basically wasting time and effort. Furthermore, if you don't know that one bug report is closed and another one's open, you might actually try to address the problem, and that would waste time as well. The idea is that we really want triagers to merge the duplicate reports in order to make fixing bug reports easier for developers. So prior work tends to compare duplicate bug reports by looking at its categorical features, things like the status, the type, the priority, or the component, the version, these kinds of attributes, these categories of the bug. Whereas other research tends to focus on the text, what's written, the subject, the description, the words in there, and how those relate. And they'll use text differencing to compare them. Some approaches will use both. For instance, Sun et al. Uses both textual similarity and categorical similarity. They use BM25F in order to measure the similarity between texts, and they also compare, say, the categorical features like a priority. Note, this is a comparison between two bugs. We're trying to find if two bugs are duplicates or not. Other researchers tend to focus on textual and categorical comparisons, and some even do stack traces, which is a good example of relying on context of bug reports. So what our methodology focuses on is extending the textual similarity and categorical similarity by adding contextual similarity. So text and categories, we're now adding contextual measurement. And contextual measurement is basically the domain knowledge of software engineering. We want to exploit that. So the idea is, instead of using an off-the-shelf component, a component off-the-shelf like BM25F for text similarity and information retrieval tools and machine learning tools, we can leverage software engineering knowledge and use that to help us deduplicate bugs. The knowledge would be the context, whether it's architecture, say like the Android architecture and related words, or it's things related to software quality like non-functional requirements, such as maintainability, portability, usability, efficiency, things like that. Or it could be system-specific data that's automatically extracted by LDA or semi-automatic by a labeled LDA. We also investigate English random words to make sure that our context stuff isn't just adding overfitting features. So we wanted to evaluate this contextual approach, and we used the Android bug repo. It's got 40k bug reports, and 1,000 of them were marked as dupes. In order to mark a bug as related to efficiency or functionality, we use BM25F to basically compare a word list of efficiency words or functionality words, and we compare them to the bug report's textual features. And then we record that number, and this allows us to do differences later. So what we effectively train on is we have pairs of bugs, and we've got their textual comparisons and their categorical comparisons, and now we're adding their contextual values and their contextual similarity. And then we use this in order to say if these two are a dupe or not. Because it is comparisons, it means when we have 40k bugs, we have 40,000 by 40,000 comparisons. This is a lot. So we try to cut this down by sampling data sets of 20% and 80%. 20% dupe, 80% not dupe. And then we evaluate machine learners on these data sets using accuracy, the correct classified rate, kappa, correlation among raters, and AUC, the area under the curve. And we do this using cross-folds validation, 10-folds cross-folds validation. So now we've got a comparison. Using machine learners, we've got Sun et al.'s work, where we have reasonable accuracy in kappas and AUCs. But then we add context, and we get an improvement in performance across most of the learners. And what's neat about this is the KNN learner has an improvement in performance, implying that distance measures have some kind of indication in this case of if bugs are duplicate or not, which is a nice property. And then, so we had an improvement when we added them together, but what if we just compared context to the textual and categorical measurements of Sun et al. And yeah, we get an improvement. So the context stuff, in some cases, provides some improvement and allows us to get some more explanatory power. And it also implies that maybe these things say similar things or slightly different things. If we look at the ROC curves, we can see that without context, the performance is at the bottom, but by adding context, we boost performance quite a bit. So our tool tends to work pretty well. So an example of a successful dupe find would be these two bugs. Bluetooth does not work with voice dialer and needs the ability to use the voice dial over Bluetooth, but sometimes it makes mistakes. If we scroll down to the bottom, number 4, we can see we got enhanced low-level Bluetooth support and Bluetooth done pan tethering support. The truth is these aren't dupes, yet our algorithm predicted them as dupes. When we looked at if adding random words, random noise, had any effect, and yeah, it has a small effect, but having 20 extra features doesn't seem to help as much as actually having good features, like contextual features. What we're basically showing is that the context has better performance. By adding the contextual information, we get better performance, and it's not just more features, although more features seems to help a little bit. In conclusion, we want to help save developers time and effort by considering the context of bug reports. And we do this by leveraging domain knowledge rather than just using straight off-the-shelf components. And we do this in order to help detect duplicates more accurately. Thank you very much.